Joby Aviation is one of the major players in the evolving market of eVTOLs. This company has raised more money than any other competitor. With the new deal between Joby and Toyota for $500 million, the overall funding has grown to $2.26 billion. Also, the company is about halfway through FAA certification, and it has also announced commercial services in the UAE in early 2026. The first commercial flights are set to take place in late 2025. How is Joby better than its competitors? I've analyzed the changes that the company has made for the last 2 years, and they seem to be heading in the right direction. First of all, the concept of the eVTOL is quite unique. It has moving propellers that can change their angle and thus provide better efficiency. The body of the Joby machine resembles a small plane, so once it reaches the needed altitude, the wings support the height, while the propellers turn to an almost horizontal position and work to push the eVTOL forward. This idea is not new, but in the Joby Aviation prototype, it works as it should. I see one problem in the propeller system. The majority of eVTOL concepts and prototypes have at least 8 propellers, sometimes much more than that. This allows them to easily redistribute power between propellers if something goes wrong with one or even 2 electric motors. In the case with Joby, it only has 6 propellers, and it's hard to imagine that the aircraft will land safely if one or 2 motors fail. Noise is another significant concern of people when it comes to eVTOLs. Propellers make high-pitched noise that is not pleasant for most humans, so if you imagine a dozen eVTOLs flying over your head, this makes you cringe a little. Joby assures that they were able to create really quiet propellers, and the fact that there are just 6 of them is a big advantage, at least in this case. The cruise speed is claimed to be 200 miles per hour or about 325 kilometers per hour. This is 10 times faster than the average speed of a car in city traffic. So it will take you 10 minutes to fly from one edge of New York City to another. The eVTOL can carry about 1,000 pounds of payload. This is not that much, but the machine is considered to be used as an air taxi only, so this payload seems to be sufficient for the main purpose. Currently, the eVTOL is claimed to be piloted, but I'm sure they are also working on technologies to make it completely autonomous. When it comes to certification, Joby Aviation has completed 2 steps out of 5 to be certified by the FAA in the US and become a commercial aircraft model, but the remaining 3 steps aren't going to be easy to complete. Joby stock prices have been stagnating for a couple of years now, without major moves up or down. The news about additional funding usually creates peaks in prices, but the price comes back to its normal position quickly after that. For now, the major investors are Toyota, Delta Airlines, and Uber, with other companies adding their funds gradually. It's not that cheap to create a safe and reliable eVTOL, and Joby has already spent about $2 billion trying to do that. After about a year, we are going to see this machine carrying first passengers in Dubai and competing with other eVTOL brands. Although there are a lot of problems to be solved, air mobility is coming into our lives to make our trips shorter and somewhat more exciting.